To make your Linux Mint Cinnamon look and work the way you want, you can change themes, add applets, desklets, and extensions. These things give your desktop a cool look and offer many options. Let's check out all the cool ways you can customize it. Let's discuss how you can change how your Linux Mint Cinnamon desktop looks and works. This might seem like a small thing, but it's actually important, especially to let more people know about this awesome free operating system. If you haven't tried it yet, which is surprising, or if you're already using it happily but haven't looked into these details much, you might find the video interesting. After installing Linux Mint, a welcome window appears with the First Steps section. It suggests customizing colors or trying a dark theme as an alternative to the default one. The welcome window is just the beginning of how you can change the appearance of Linux Mint Cinnamon. To further customize, open the Themes option in the Preferences menu. Here, you can edit individual components to create unique style combinations. Explore the Add Remove tab to find numerous themes crafted and updated by passionate Linux Mint users. Download a theme and add its components to others for a consistent look or more combinations. While it's impractical to describe them all, you can view screenshots of the most popular or latest themes on the official website. You can download themes from there or do so more quickly within the system. On the right side of the Cinnamon panel, you'll find Linux Mint applets. These are informative icons and quick access points to programs and various settings. They cover calendar and clock settings, system update status, audio control, printer access, and more. To adjust applet settings, right-click the central part of the panel and choose applets, or simply type applet in the menu and press enter. Some applets cannot be removed, as indicated by the lock icon. Clicking the gear icon lets you change any settings. Activate applets with the plus button and remove them with the minus button at the bottom of the window. You can download additional applets, though they are not created by the Mint team. Switch from the Download tab, select an applet, go back to Manage, and activate it with the plus button. For a convenient overview of available applets, or if you haven't installed Linux Mint yet, check the official website. Let's look at a couple of pre-installed and active applets. To change the clock display to show the date on two lines, similar to Windows, right-click on the clock, click Configure, and select Use a Custom Date Format. Enter %R, %N, %X in the field. To also display seconds, add %S after the %R. The configuration page allows further customization of the date and time format. Among the installed but inactive applets, there's one for switching workspaces, placing four buttons in the panel for a preview and easy movement between virtual desktops. Another applet, Expo, provides a full-screen preview of workspaces but can be less useful compared to the Ctrl-Alt-Upward-Arrow shortcut. Finally, there's the trash if you prefer not to use the desktop icon. And the on-screen keyboard, a default and functional solution for touchscreen and other cases. Among the first unofficial downloadable applets worth mentioning are Cinnamonu and Syn7 Stock Menu. Cinnamonu offers an alternative menu to the default one, providing numerous options such as a grid view, web searches on various engines, and history access. On the other hand, Syn7 Stock Menu mimics the menu of Windows 7 or the Mate environment, also offering web searches and various options. If you want to replace the default menu with either of these, activate the chosen applet, then right-click in an open area of the panel and select Panel Edit Mode. Drag the new menu to the left side, turn off Edit Mode, and remove the default menu by right-clicking and choosing Remove Menu. Importantly, this action doesn't uninstall the default menu. You can easily reactivate it whenever you want through the Manage window. The Lock Keys Indicator applet is lightweight and displays the status of Caps Lock, Numeric Keypad, and Scroll Lock on the panel. It also lets you set desktop notifications for changes in these lock statuses. The weather applet is well designed with plenty of customization options. It's subtle, matching the Linux Mint look. You can set multiple locations with precise coordinates, and it shows the current weather symbol and temperature. Clicking reveals more details and forecasts, including hourly predictions for the day. Open Weather Map provides the monitoring and forecasting service. Radio Plus Plus is a great find, integrating a browser and search engine for thousands of radio stations. It allows you to quickly find and add your favorite stations, displays artist and title information, tracks like songs, and even supports song downloads. Redshift, pre-installed in Linux Mint's accessories menu, adjusts monitor color temperature in the evening to reduce sleep disturbances. Q Redshift applet enhances this by allowing you to change activation times, brightness, gamma, and color temperature from a single window. The timer with notifications applet helps you set countdowns, track time, and get visual and audible notifications upon completion. It offers many customization options. Developers passionate about Linux Mint create various applets, including real-time monitoring tools for resource use, CPU temperature, and network traffic speed. However, some may compromise desktop stability. For limited panel space, consider Desklets for these needs. Other interesting applets cater to graphic designers, developers, systems engineers, and tasks like managing copy and paste history or converting text into QR codes. Explore them yourself, but avoid cluttering the panel space and RAM memory unless needed during Linux Mint sessions. Instead, start these applications only when necessary to conserve resources. Linux Mint Desklets are small applications designed for the Cinnamon desktop, similar to Windows widgets and other Linux distributions. They allow you to display various types of information on your desktop, such as clocks, calendars, weather updates, real-time system information, and other downloadable content from the internet. To manage Desklets, right-click on the desktop and choose Add Desklet. You'll notice that there are only three created by the Mint team and pre-installed. Although they are not active, they cannot be uninstalled. You can activate them with the plus button at the bottom of the window and remove them with the minus button. When configuration settings are available, a clickable gear icon appears if the Desklet is on the screen. Clicking on the X permanently uninstalls them. The first Desklet is a digital clock that you can customize for size and a custom time format. Next is the digital photo frame, which is a customizable slideshow that draws images from a defined folder, playing them sequentially or in random order. Lastly, the Launcher Desklet provides an icon on the desktop to open system settings. With a right-click, you can change its behavior to launch another program or a bash script. The launcher feature is quite intriguing, especially when managed with a right-click on the desktop followed by Create a New Launcher here. However, its primary use isn't for creating icons of programs or system settings on the desktop, as this can be done more quickly from the menu with a right-click and Add to Desktop. Instead, its real utility lies in creating graphical icons for programs downloaded in the app image format that don't come with built-in icons due to not being officially installed. Consider wanting Inkscape, the Adobe Illustrator of the free world, without installing an outdated version from the official repositories or the data-heavy Flatpak version. In such cases, you might opt for the 120 MB AppImage version. Once you permit the file to run as a program, an AppImage opens, but you won't find it in the menu, and adding its icon to the desktop isn't straightforward. Creating a launcher is the solution. Enter the name, search for an appropriate icon by clicking on the missile icon, browse until you select the file, indicate if you want a comment, and an icon is generated on the desktop. Additionally, an other category is created in the menu where you can locate it. It can be useful to change the position of an app image in the menu. Access the menu configuration by right-clicking the button, selecting Configure, and on the Menu tab, click the Open the Menu Editor button. In the Other category, select the program, cut it, choose the destination category, and paste. Voila! The AppImage Program Launcher is now in the appropriate category. let's move away from the three pre-installed Desklets and explore the download tab. If you pick one and click on the light bulb icon, your default browser opens to the official Desklet page, where you can find screenshots, read or leave comments. However, it's easier to download and install them directly from this window. Currently, there are about 50 Desklets created by developers in the Linux Mint community. While some may seem a bit outdated, they are often quite updated. Some may come with warnings after installation, explaining that they contain instructions not entirely compatible with the current version of Cinnamon. Among the most noteworthy Desklets for monitoring system conditions, disk space stands out. When added to your desktop, this circular graph, customizable with themes and by size, displays the percentage of used space on your Linux system partition along with the actual size and total space. You can tweak settings to monitor different partitions, RAM memory, or swap file size. The Desklet also allows you to assign actions like opening the file manager, partition manager, or system monitor. What's cool is that you can add multiple Desklets to your desktop, each independently editable with a right click, providing a way to keep track of various information simultaneously. Another useful Desklet is Simple System Monitor, which displays CPU and RAM usage percentages, incoming and outgoing traffic speed, and CPU temperature in a minimalistic and text-only format. Clock Desklets are handy, especially when not at the computer, and the screensaver hasn't started yet. The Time and Date Desklet is a recommended option, offering customization in format, size, and colors. Among the analog desk clocks, Kobe Analog Clock stands out for its themes. Weather Desklet, drawing data from the BBC service, is customizable by copying the numeric code of the location from the website. It connects to various services and has extensive customization options. For those following financial markets, the Yahoo Finance Quotes Desklet allows customization of a list of symbols, indices, stocks, assets, and currencies, along with appearance and update options. For music enthusiasts, Soundbox displays audio settings and media controls for programs playing audio. It integrates with audio and video playback on streaming websites with Firefox and Chromium-based browsers, displaying cover art and offering various themes. To wrap up the Desklet recommendations, Mitu groups screen lock, session end, restart, and shutdown commands into a single widget. When it comes to extensions, my enthusiasm wanes compared to earlier. Instead of adding utility, they tend to introduce effects of questionable taste, often incompatible with the current version of Linux Mint. These extensions, aimed at special effects, frequently create more problems than delivering awe-inspiring experiences. Unfortunately, these effects tend to perform poorly and are not beneficial for the stability of Linux Mint. I don't believe Linux Mint is the ideal operating system for such enhancements. The typical Linux Mint user, in my opinion, values the system for its simplicity and functionality, rather than seeking flashy effects. If someone is interested in these kinds of features, they might be better off choosing a different Linux distribution. Linux Mint, along with its desktop, prioritizes offering an essential, sober, pleasant, customizable, and distraction-free environment. It is designed to work seamlessly on older computers with limited resources, even those with 4 GB of RAM or less. One extension worth mentioning, however, is the Window Auto Tiling extension, similar to that of Pop! OS. This extension discreetly allows for the rearrangement of open windows on the screen based on various criteria, providing a functional enhancement without compromising the system's stability. If you prefer an appearance similar to that of a Mac desktop, navigate to the Windows option in the menu under Preferences. Move the button's layout to the left, and install a dock from the Software Manager to replace the Linux Mint panel and menu. Plank is a recommended choice for a lightweight option. However, cairo-dock, while feature-rich, can be somewhat invasive due to its extensive customization options. Before deactivating the Cinnamon panel to test these docks, right-click on the panel itself, go to Panel Settings, and activate Auto Hide Panel. This way, you can use cairo-dock and Plank by revealing the panel only when needed, by moving the arrow to the lowest point of the desktop. for plank, launch it, and with the control key and a right click, access the preferences. You can customize the appearance, position, behavior, activate animations, and add Desklets to open all Linux Mint programs with a right click, bypassing the Cinnamon menu. In cairo-dock, you can access preferences with right-click cairo-dock configure. However, exploring all the options can be a substantial task. Be cautious, as cairo-dock may not be as stable and has experienced crashes. If you decide to uninstall it, note that cairo-dock plugins might not be removed automatically. To clear everything, use the command sudo apt purge cairo-dock in the terminal. For permanent use of plank or cairo-dock, include them among the applications that start with the system. Open the menu, type start, press enter, and use the plus sign at the bottom of the window to add your dock. To remove the panel, Cinnamon menu, and applets, right-click on the panel and select remove. It will ask for double confirmation to remove everything. To reactivate it, type Cinnamon Settings Panel in a terminal window, click Add New Panel, and then reposition it. If there are issues with the panel, right-click on it, select Troubleshoot, and choose Restore All Settings to Default. I haven't done it yet, but I recommend using Desklets, Applets, and extensions in moderation. Excessive use not only demands more RAM than the default Linux Mint settings, but can also adversely impact the stability of the Cinnamon desktop. While these are verified by the team, and potential conflicts with the Cinnamon desktop environment are reported if necessary, it's wise to exercise caution. Starting from Linux Mint 20.2, a control mechanism has been implemented to prevent programming defects from consuming excessive RAM. The desktop's RAM memory limit is now customizable. When the threshold is surpassed, the desktop restarts without any loss of information or closing of open applications. As mentioned earlier, the Linux Mint team is actively working to enhance the performance, stability, and updates of the Cinnamon desktop with significant changes. While the immediate compatibility of additional applets and desklets may be influenced, it doesn't imply a lasting problem. If you found this video helpful in transforming your Linux Mint Cinnamon desktop, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and share it with others who might be looking to customize their desktop too. Subscribe to the channel for more Linux tips, tricks, and in-depth tutorials. Your support keeps me motivated to bring you valuable content. If you have any questions or suggestions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching.